Satnam, in the last video, I spoke to you about what you need to do to fortify the body so that you deal with the virus more effectively. Today, I'm going to talk to you about what you need to do to the mind to make the mind strong and deal with the virus from a psychological point of view so that your mental outlook is so positive that your body builds up more immunity. Before I begin, I'm going to tell you a story. It's a true story of an actress who used to come to my classes long ago. And she was perpetually depressed. And she used to talk to me and she used to say, I'm not getting any work. And, you know, I got married and I have a baby. So now, you know, they're not casting me anymore. And I used to say that, you know, I used to tell her that, look, you need to be happy where you are now. When whatever situation you're in, you need to find that balance within your life, within your mind, so that you accept that situation and be happy. And she would say, no, but I need work. I need work. I need work. And then she got work. And she would be shooting every day. And I, you know, you would imagine that she should be thrilled and she should be really happy about it. But she came to my class and she started crying. I said, what happened to you now? What's so upsetting, you know, that you're crying now? And she said, I'm shooting so much that I'm waking up early in the morning. I see my baby, she's sleeping, and I leave the house and I come back after my shooting at home at night and she's sleeping. I'm not getting time with my husband. I'm not getting time with my family. I can't see my friend. And now she was depressed because she had too much work. Why am I telling you this story? I'm telling you this story because life throws different kinds of situations at us all the time. The ones who are complainers, the ones who don't accept the reality as it is, will always complain about the reality they're in, no matter what kind of reality they're in. In this situation that you're in now with the coronavirus, if you're sitting at home doing nothing, that should not be a problem. It should be an opportunity for you to do things that you were never able to do before. Mental positivity begins with understanding the fact that in life, we need to accept the situation we are in right now and deal with it. The most important thing to create the positivity in the mind that you need to understand is that you need to have a relationship with the sun. Yes, just because you are in self-isolation and you're homebound doesn't mean that you cannot go up to your terrace or just go out to your compound and just stand out in the sun. In fact, I can go one step further and say that if your balcony faces the sun, or if you can go up to the terrace when the sun rises, look at the sun directly. Look into the sun directly. Just as it hits the horizon and starts coming up, look at the sun. Look at it for 5 minutes. Look at it for 7 minutes. And you see what happens to the state of mind and how much positivity it creates. I use this as a cure for depression, which means it creates so much positivity in the mind that it can even cure a depression. So use this, use the sun, make the sun your best friend, and it really, really, really is a very healing thing. Okay, next up, exercise. Just because you're at home, you can't go to the gym, you can't play your badminton, you can't swim, doesn't mean that you cannot roll up your mat and just do some Surya Namaskar. What I recommend is that you Google something called the 5 Tibetan Rites. Do the 5 Tibetan Rites followed by 11 Surya Namaskars, and you just see how much difference does that make to you. It's amazing. It's like the combination of the two will hardly take you 30 minutes, but this exercise by itself, just the 5 Tibetan Rites, 21 sets of that and 11 Surya Namaskars, it'll take you half an hour and your full body will be energized, your chakras will be balanced. It feels great. It feels amazing. Walking. Ever since I've been in self-isolation and I've been, you know, bound to my home and not leaving my building, I have been walking 3 times a day, at least round and round my building, because the whole act of walking is one of the best exercises for you anyway. You don't need equipment for it and it's there for you, especially after you've had your lunch and your dinner. You must in any case walk. The Maharashtrians call it Shat Pauli and the Chinese call it the 100 steps. The 100 steps is something which you must do after you've eaten. So as an exercise also, and for the digestion also, if you just walk for 15-20 minutes, it's really good for your brain and it really, really, really creates a sense of positivity in you. Next up, your hobbies. Now, I've been a stamp collector for half my life. And for the last 15 years, I've had no time to, you know, go back to any of my hobbies because I've been so busy. But this is the time. You collect something, you have a stamp collection, bring it out. You like reading, read. Whatever you want to do. My wife just started origami. My daughter's learning to cook. Why just sit home and vegetate in front of Netflix? Netflix is good, but that's not what you should be doing the whole day anyway, according to me. Talking about Netflix, you must know one really important thing. To create the positivity in the mind, watch positive things. If you're watching Game of Thrones, you're watching any show which is macabre, which is gory, which has got a lot of violence in it, which has got a lot of... No, this is not the time for it. And if you love Pugby, throw it out of the window. Trust me. When we watch something positive, it creates an aura of positivity in us. In fact, I'll go one step further and tell you that I don't ever, ever watch anything which is violent. I don't ever watch anything to do with horror. I never see a horror film in my life, ever. Well, at least not for the last 15 years. So, what you watch is really important for the state of mind you're in. If you're watching violence, if you're watching sad stories, if you're watching, you know, gory stuff, horror films, if you want the positivity that we're discussing in this video, forget about it, not happening. The most important thing that I want to discuss last is the food that you eat. Yes, you love those bourbon biscuits, you love chaknas, you love your alcohol. What goes into your stomach gives out the chemicals that go to your brain, and depending on what you've eaten, those are the kind of chemicals that go out. If you've eaten garbage, your thoughts are going to be garbage. If you're eating sattvic food, if your food is sattva, your brain is going to be sattva. If your food is full of positivity, if you're eating fruits, you're eating vegetables, I know, maybe they're not available, but at least if you're even having dal chawal, which you have saved in your house, if you're having the grains, whatever you're having, if it's positive, if it's not garbage, if it's not just bread, biscuits, noodles, packaged foods, if you're eating all of that, I promise you, you cannot stay positive. Okay, so be really conscious about the food. So that's it for the mind today. Just to run through a quick recap, remember, you are a human being, you're not a human doing. Just because you have nothing to do doesn't mean that life has come to an end. Just be, meditate if you have to, it's beautiful. Remember that you need to have a relationship with the sun, exercise, walk, go back to your hobbies, don't watch anything negative, don't watch anything gory, don't watch anything violent, it creates negativity in the mind. And lastly, eat healthy, nutritious, good sattvic food. There are more videos coming out. The next one is to do with spirituality of the situation we are in. What is the spirituality of the situation that we are in? That's what we're doing next. Subscribe to the YouTube channel or follow Anahata Retreats on Facebook. And I'll see you soon. Satnam.